Good day. Today's topic was recommended by one of our fellow FPV pilots, sub-250G FPV, and I want to thank him for it, because he's absolutely correct. It's time we've had this difficult conversation about this uncomfortable topic. We all know what it is. Failure to launch. It's afflicted many FPV pilots. But take heart, I'm here to tell you today there is a cure. And we've got the right prescription for you. BetaFlight Launch Control. So by the end of this video, no FPV pilot should ever again suffer needlessly from failure to launch. Stay tuned. All right, the first thing we need to do for the launch control is to go into our model setup under mixer, and we're going to add a switch for launch control. We're going to scroll down to an open channel. I've got a lot of things set up here on mine, so we're going to find an open channel. Channel 13 is open, so we're going to click on that, and we're going to name it launch. Then we're going to scroll down to source. I'm going to use this potentiometer switch up here as my source, all the way over to the right. So when I move that, you'll see this source option change to potentiometer, which I believe is switch 2. Yes, switch 2. Now I've got the potentiometer set all the way over to the right hand side, and that's what's going to activate my launch control. Now that I'm done, I hit exit. That's all there is to it. We have to remember that I've got it set up on channel 13, which is aux 9. So we'll go into the Betaflight modes tab and set it up on aux 9. Okay, if you go to the Betaflight wiki under github.com, it explains launch control with a description, safety concerns, the launch procedure, mode switch configuration, and the various parameters to include launch trigger, allow reset, launch control mode, trigger throttle percent, launch control gain, etc. All right, to set up launch control in Betaflight, we go to the configuration tab, and the first thing we need to do is make sure that our accelerometer is turned on, and we also have air mode on, which we do. Save and reboot. Then we go into our modes tab, scroll down to launch control, add range. Remember, we're on aux 9, channel 13. There's a little yellow blip. When we switch our potentiometer switch 2 on our QX7 all the way to the right, you'll see the little blip move over here. And that is when launch control is enabled. When I rotate the potentiometer switch 2 to the left, it is no longer active. And that's exactly what we want. So now we have our switch working on aux 9 for launch control. Click save. Saved over here. Then we need to go into our CLI. And as we mentioned earlier, we want to configure these parameters the way we desire in our CLI. For our case, we want our launch control mode to be pitch only, which is for use with a race launch stand, and it disables roll and yaw completely. We also want the launch trigger allow reset to on, which is default. On allows the pilot to reset the launch control trigger by turning the mode switch off and back on again while disarmed, which is what we're able to do with our switch 2 potentiometer the way we set it up. Use this method if you configured mode switch in such a way that you can optionally enable it, which is what we've done. We also want to change our launch trigger throttle percent to a different number. The default is 20. We're going to leave launch control gain as is. The default is 40. We do have our accelerometer enabled, so we're going to change our accelerometer integration launch angle limit to something higher than zero. I'm thinking about 35 degrees. And we're also going to enable our OSD warning launch control to on. The way we're going to do this is we're going to copy and paste these into our CLI. Hit enter. And now we've got the launch control mode set to pitch only, the launch trigger allow reset set to on, the launch trigger throttle percent set to 45. So when we increase our throttle above 45, that's when the quad's going to launch. And we've got the launch angle limit set to 45 degrees. Our OSD warning launch control is set to on, so that means we will get warnings on our OSD display, as well as we should see the launch angle displayed on our OSD. We need to remember to click Save. Hit Enter. And we should be good to go. Friends, you've seen the results. There is hope. We can eradicate FTL from our FPV community, but we need your help. Spread the word and get your BetaFlight launch control treatment today. We'll see you next time. Clear skies, my friends.